So I promised you that if you put your suggestions in the description of one of my Get Ready For Me videos recently, that I would run down some better movies. And so today I'm going to talk about my favorite vintage Christmas movies. Come along. Counting down from five, number five is Planes, Trains, and Automobiles. And if you're American like I am, hear me out, because yes, this is a Thanksgiving movie, but we, as in Lawrence and I and our household, have a tradition, and it has spanned the years, where we, after we are finished with our Thanksgiving dinner, sit down and watch this film every single year. And I did watch it a couple of times growing up, but because I was too young, I don't think that it actually held the same kind of meaning for me as it does now. But Lawrence, on the other hand, of course, was obsessed with America and American things from the time he was very, very small. So he watched this film quite a lot growing up and absolutely loves it to the point where he can probably quote you things from the film. And I enjoy it too, because I always like a John Hughes movie. The duo of Steve Martin and John Candy is irreplaceable, really, in comedic history. And it just makes for a really entertaining watch that rings us into the holiday season every single year. Fourth on the list is Babes in Toyland, which is a classic but largely forgotten film from the 50s starring Annette Funicello. And growing up, it used to be one of my favorite movies to put on while I drew or played with dolls around the Christmas season. It's one of those films that there really isn't a lot going on throughout it. It is quite zany at points, and it's very silly. But the soundtrack is excellent, and I have just recently rewatched this film, and it checks all of the best ambient watches for me. So the soundtrack is great. Everything is very low key, and everyone in it is at least mildly humorous. And then Annette Funicello specifically is someone who, as a kid, I really loved growing up, to the point where I had pictures of her in my notebooks as a preteen. My uncle used to call me his little flower child, because I was more obsessed with things in the 60s than I was in the 90s when I was growing up, mostly. So for me, Annette Funicello was like the it star, even though no one my age had ever heard of her. It's a really, really good movie to put on in the background while you're doing things. I wouldn't necessarily recommend, unless you have really small children, sitting through the entire thing, because it's very, very long. But I really enjoyed it when I rewatched it in the background recently. Number three on this list is very controversial, and I didn't know that growing up. Now, I am well aware of why it is. In fact, if you would like to know more about blackface, then let me know in the comments below, and I will tell you all about the problematic history of blackface at some point, but that's not for this video today. In case you haven't already guessed, number three on the list is Holiday Inn, because outside of the awkward Abraham song, this film has one of the best soundtracks ever, and it just happens to be the first film where we hear White Christmas. Not the film White Christmas, believe it or not, but Holiday Inn. When I was probably 16 or 17 years old, I made what I at least imagined the real life house of the set of White Christmas on that farm to be in The Sims 2, and it still remains one of my favorite ever builds. So maybe I'll need to make it again sometime. Holiday Inn, well worth a watch. That difficult song wasn't actually in the cut that you would watch on TV. So that's why for a really long time, I didn't even know that it existed. But now that I do, it is a little bit problematic and I would skip through that part, but the rest of the film is really, really good. Now, while Holiday Inn is arguably the better of the two films, White Christmas, I think, deserves the spot on number two, merely because it really is a Christmas film. You could argue that Holiday Inn is about all of the holidays, but for me, it only gets played at Christmas. White Christmas, on the other hand, is kind of the sequel to Holiday Inn. It's really kind of, I don't know, it's a bit of a stretch to call it a sequel. White Christmas, of course, has all of the Christmas songs, and It also has, I think, the better kind of Christmas atmosphere throughout the film. I think I'll go with White Christmas over The Holiday if I really had to choose, but they're a pair, they belong together. In the meantime, I have a really, really exciting recipe video coming tomorrow, and the members of the Crafty Club helped me choose what kind of recipe it was going to be. So if you would like to help me decide the fate of this channel through polls and sometimes discussions on Discord and on Patreon, then you can also become a senior member of the Crafty Club and you'll get access to all of those things, as well as a pretty big archive of old videos that I have done exclusively for members. The link, as ever, is in the description below. And then finally, without much ado, the number one slot on my vintage Christmas movie list has to go to It's a Wonderful Life. That was my own family's traditional holiday film that we would watch whenever it came on. And it also was one of my dad's favorite movies his entire life. So whenever I watch it now, since his passing, I think of him. And I think of just all of the memories that I have of him, especially, you know, here at Christmas time. Even if I separate those memories, it's a damn good film. It has all of it. It has suspense, it has romance, it has action, it has Jimmy Stewart, which you can't really improve on that. But I just can't say enough about everything having to do with this film. Even if Clarence is a little bit hokey as a character, even just as a YouTuber and an artist, the cinematography and the editing and the way that the film was made, given that it's analog and in black and white, is just beautiful to watch. If you haven't seen it, then you should definitely give it a go. And I will see you tomorrow for another Vlogmas video.